Here we have got three voltages, that means V1, V2 and V3. V1 is for resistor 1 and V2 is for resistor 2 and V3 is for resistor 3. So, as we know, these are all given by Ohm's law. So, V is equal to IR, that is known as Ohm's law. So, accordingly, here for resistor 1, V1 is equal to IR1, for 2, V2 is equal to IR2, and for 3, V3 is equal to IR3. Hence, the supply voltage V is the sum of all individual voltage drops across each resistance. Okay, so here the explanation is there, that is total V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, that means the summation of all voltage, that is divided in different components, the summation of those voltages is equal to the total voltage. Hence, for V1, the value is IR1, for V2, the value is IR2, and for V3, the value is IR3. Similarly, for V, the value is IR, these values are according to Ohm's law. So, from this, we can take common I, because I is same across all resistors, I has same value. So, we can take I as common. So, IR is equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. So, this implies IR is equal to I taken common, then the value is R1 plus R2 plus R3. Then both sides, I is there and that is in multiplication form. So, it gets cancelled. So, the R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. That means the total resistance is equal to the different, all total individual resistances connected in that circuit. So, R is equal to RT or REQ. That means RT is known as total resistance and REQ, that means it is known as equivalent resistance. All three are same. R is the total resistance, RT is also the total resistance, and R equivalent is also the total resistance. So this is the summation of all three individual resistors are connected in series, then the total resistance is R or RT or REQ is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Then we found that if a number of resistances are connected in series, then the total resistance or equivalent resistance of this combination means series combination or connection. We can say combination, we can say connection, both are same. So, this combination, that is series connection, is the sum of the individual resistances. Okay. So, next comes voltage division rule. Voltage division rule is related to series combination. How? We'll study here. Okay, how voltage division rule is connected with series combination, how they are related. Okay, as we know, in series connection, voltage is divided into across all resistors, all individual resistors. So, the total V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 up to Vn. This is a series connection case. So, how it is related to voltage division rule? Voltage division rule is one of the basic rules of the circuit analysis. Okay. It is applicable to all series circuits. That means, voltage division rule is only applicable for series circuits. That is not applicable for parallel circuit. That is only applicable for series circuits. So, series circuit always acts as a voltage divider. That means voltage divider means voltage is divided. that is known as voltage divider. In a series circuit, the same current flows through each resistance. The voltage drop is proportional to the value of resistors. Here it says the current value across each element in the voltage in the circuit is same, but the voltage is different. That is in series circuits. Okay, the voltage drop is proportional to the value of resistors. That is directly proportional. So, using this principle, different voltages can be obtained from a single source called a voltage divider. So, now we will see explanation how. In the circuit given below, we have to determine the value of V1 and V2. Hence, the total current is given by the total voltage divided by its equivalent resistance. Here in the figure, it is given that V is the supply voltage, I is the current, supply current flowing through the circuit. Then V1 and V2 are the voltages across resistor 1 and resistor 2. Here, resistor 1, R1, and resistor 2, R2, both are connected in series. That means here voltage is divided. Okay, but same amount of current flows through R1 also R2. Okay, here R equivalent means R total or R. Simply you can write R, you can write RT, and also you write R equivalent. All three are same. Okay, so R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2. There are two resistors only, so R1 plus R2 due to series connection. Okay, here bracket, in this bracket it is written that due to series connection. For series connection, R equivalent we will calculate how, that is for R1 plus R2, then R equivalent is there. So I is there, I is equal to, as we know, V is equal to I R by Ohm's law, then I is equal to V by R. So, I is equal to V by R equivalent. That means R equivalent is R1 plus R2. Then putting this value instead of R equivalent, we will get I is equal to V by R1 plus R2. Here, V1 is equal to I R1. That is equation number 1. Then, putting the value of I in equation number 1, we will get V by R1 plus R2 into R1. Okay. Then V1 is equal to V into R1 by R1 plus R2. This is the simplification form. Okay, just simple mathematics. Similarly, V2 is equal to IR2. Here also we can put the value of I and we will get the result. That means V2 is equal to IR2. This implies V by R1 plus R2 into whole into R2. That means V2 is equal to V into R2 by R1 plus R2. This is equation number 3. Okay, understood. So that means the voltage division rule, the voltages are divided. So thus the voltage division rule stated as the voltage across any resistor in a series connection of resistors will be equal to the ratio of the value of the resistor divided by the equivalent resistance of the circuit. Okay, now we will study about the resistances connected in parallel. How? Let's see.